I cannot hardly express or keep up with what's going on. But I'll hit the record button and tape it anyway. Very profound what's going on. Very, very, very profound. So how do I feel? How does it feel when you reach this very, getting into the very profound? Well, fine, no problem. Functioning's fine. I still feel hungry. And the day is the day. Everything is the same. But dreams are a little different, very positive, actually. Some amazing events took place in the dream, and I realized that something is coming for sure. As I've said, something is coming for sure. There's no question about it. So how does that feel to know that, you know, situation is going to improve in seemingly unfathomable ways to most people? Well, I feel fine. Not worried, not disturbed or anything. Just like, okay, get up in the morning and just keep working. The work ethic is very important. Just keep your stride. However much progress you make, you know, the day is for making even more, going even faster. But I will say the videos that I have taped, they're certainly on track. It's, again, I do not have a confusion problem, I have a continuity problem. This is so incredibly important. Cannot overemphasize it enough. It's the heart of truth. It's the heart of truth. Again, to say that I have a confusion problem is complete arrogance and desire to displace the Prime Creator. Because what we're really saying is, hey, I'm confused. How come I can't displace the Prime Creator? What am I doing wrong? It's like saying, trying to do the impossible and saying, I'm really confused about this. No, there's no confusion. Literally, there is no confusion whatsoever. There is no confusion. This is a misdefinition. There's the impossible, but there is no confusion. We cannot say, I'm confused. Why can't I? What am I doing wrong? I'm trying to change what can't be changed. What am I doing wrong? I'm confused. That is delusion. We have a continuity problem, yes, in that all of this form and motion within spaciousness, we're so used to that, identifying with that. We say, what do we do with all this? We have a continuity problem. We don't have a confusion problem. There's no confusion at all taking place. So anyone who comes into the world trying to help, the world insists they have a confusion problem. They say, oh great, you're here to help me with my confusion. As soon as anybody agrees to that, they are no longer enlightened. They're no longer helpful. The problem is almost everybody agrees with that. Yeah, I did too, and that's why I've not been helpful. There isn't any confusion. Nobody can clear up confusion. There isn't any. There is no, but I can help clear up the continuity problem for sure. This is a pivotal issue. Is there confusion? No. How can we say there's confusion over how to do the impossible? It's merely we have been trying to create confusion, but we've not succeeded. And to say that we're confused while we've not been able to create confusion is an absurdity. We actually have a continuity fear. See, we're misdefining the continuity fear as confusion. As soon as we do that, we are lost. We are off track. We're in a state of severe delusion. That's why we need the teachers who are not in that state of delusion to help. And they must be very insistent. I'm not here to help with confusion. I'm here to help with a continuity problem. Those who say they're confused are misdefining the continuity problem. It's out of their continued desire to change God, to change reality, to be prime creator. They're insisting, no, it's not impossible what I'm trying to do. I'm just confused as to how to do it. You see, that's not true. It's like saying all this form, a movement, that which moves, form, in pure spaciousness. You say, I'm confused. How do I define pure spaciousness through form? I'm trying to define, and so what is it that, what movements do I need to make to define pure spaciousness? The movements in pure spaciousness, I'm moving, is that defining pure spaciousness? Is that the definition? Are we defining it? No. Pure spaciousness cannot be defined. Isness cannot be defined. I am. God is I am. That cannot be defined. We're trying to define it through form. And so we say, I'm really confused. You know, do I move like this? Or do I move like that? Can you help me with my confusion? No. There's no confusion. There's no definition taking place. Zero. What confusion is there about zero? There's no confusion. It's just that we're so used to identifying with motion and form that we have a continuity issue. That's it. Nobody is actually confused. They're trying to be confused, but they're not confused. No one's confused. There is no confusion. It doesn't exist. There's all this motion, but it's doing absolutely nothing as far as defining pure spaciousness. And we're trying to add up all this motion and say, I just need to get the right motion in the ocean. And they say, please come in and help us with our definitional problems here. We're having definitional problems. Could you help us out? We're confused. We're not sure. No, there's no confusion. Is pure spaciousness confused? Is pure spaciousness saying, you know, I'm really confused. All these, I'm not sure what I am. All this motion of form, I can't figure it out. You know, what exactly am I? You know, who am I? I'm confused. Pure spaciousness is not confused. So since there isn't any confusion, we say, oh wow, I mean, this is all zero. Yeah, well, I'm afraid to just let it all go. That's a continuity problem. All the form, all the motion. Okay. All the form, all the motion. This ocean of motion we call the universe. We're afraid to have it disappear. That's a continuity fear. So we see it as zero times zero. The form is zero. The motion is zero. It's zero times zero. All of this is zero times zero. No definition. In other words, the definition is zero. We're still keeping the echo of definition and motion. But it's zero. Definition. Zero times zero. The only identity is I am. When we say individual identity, what does that mean? Form and motion? There, no, there is no such identity. My identity is the unidentified identity. That is your identity. That is the one identity. There's the one identity, which is the undefined identity. I am the undefined identity. So we don't lose our undefined identity. We share the unidentified identity. We're sharing it right now. Everyone is the unidentified identity right now. Motion and form do not identify anything, do not identify what we are, do not define what we are. There's no definition taking place at all, actually, of spaciousness. Is motion in spaciousness defining spaciousness? Doesn't spaciousness remain undisturbed by any form, motion of form? It's exactly the same, isn't it? This is not identifying anything. It's not identifying spaciousness, is it? So nothing is happening. There's absolutely nothing happening in terms of identity right now. We are all already the unidentified identity, the undefined identity. We're already that. Now, Nisargadatta says, I am that. This means I am 0, 0. I'm 0 times 0. This is an intermediate step. Actually, there is only I am. But to say I am that is to say, is an intermediate step saying I am the 0, 0ly defined form, 0ly defined motion. I am the 0, 0. I am the 0 times 0. I am the space space. I am space defining space. I am that. I am that. So we can, as it's the witness defining the witness. So we can, the observer defining the observer. I am that. I am 0 times 0. This is called the intermediate step. This is what we call enlightenment. It's still an intermediate step because actually there's only I am. But the continuity fear that we have is we say, well, I am that. I am that. Space, space. It's 0, 0. There's no motion, there's no form to it. But you're still applying space to space as if you were applying motion and form to pure spaciousness. We're saying let's symbolize pure spaciousness as space and then apply space to space. So I am that. Where am I? I am space. That's where I am. I am space in space. That's where I am. We say that intermediately. Intermediate. My identity is space, space. That's a way to symbolize I am. We don't need to leap into I am because there is no leap. We never, you can't leap into I am. Okay, so the intermediate step is to say, well, I'm space leaping into space. We can't even abide in I am. We can say I'm space abiding in space. See, I am is even beyond immediacy. It's unthinkable. Okay, it's unconceptual. Cannot conceptualize it. Cannot even think of it. Cannot even think of it at all. So we say, oh my God, I don't want to drop all my thinking, all my conceptual, all my you know, wow, it's too much. So, okay, well, think I am space abiding in space. I am that. See, confusion, to say I'm confused, is really to say I'm afraid of the, I have a severe continuity fear, I don't know what to do about it. That's what it's really saying. So I'm saying, we don't need to keep insisting we're confused, because there's this intermediate step. Space, space. Space leaping into space. I am space leaping into space. I am space expanding into space. I am space abiding in space. I am space, space. I am that. And you say, yeah. Okay, I don't need to claim I'm confused. What we say, confusion, is saying, you know, I'm really confused because I'm not sure what to multiply zero by in order to get a value. Can you help me with this? I'm really confused. I mean, I've tried all these things and it hasn't worked. So what does work? You know, what number do I multiply zero by to get a value? I'm really confused. No, there's no confusion there. There's a continuity fear. It's saying, oh my God, I know there isn't any number I can multiply zero by zero to get any result at all. I cannot define what is. I can't define it. What do I do with all these numbers? Oh my God, you know, I'm afraid to drop numbers here. Afraid to drop value. So it's really a continuity fear. Just define it that way, and your outlook completely flips like that. Totally different outlook. And suddenly you're at the feet of the guru. Just like that. When you say I'm confused, you're seeking for the guru. And you're seeking, 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 seeking. I say, I'm confused. I can't find the guru. Where is the, you know, I can't find the truth. I can't find what number is the truth. And when you say, you know, zero times zero, I only have a continuity problem, not a confusion problem. Let me accept that zero times zero is the number. Okay. Then immediately you're at the feet of the guru. Immediately you're at the feet of truth. And you're simply getting used to that. Immediately. You don't need to go anywhere. You're right there right now. There isn't any confusion. You're not confused over, you're not seeking which number to multiply zero to get a result. You said, okay, I agree. No more seeking, no more searching. I'm going to multiply zero times zero. So we already have the zero. We know where that is. So we don't need to seek that. We'll just say, I'll take what I have and I'll just multiply it, you know, by itself, zero times zero. I already have that. No seeking is necessary. No time is necessary. No, you know, no movement is necessary. No form is necessary for that. So immediately the seeking's over and you're right at the feet of the guru, right now. And then all you're doing is you're saying, yes, I see it. Yes, I get it. Yes. Oh. But I just need to get used to it. Continuity fear. Just need to get used to it. But there's no confusion. So the whole trick is to insist that you do not have a confusion problem. You have a continuity problem. Insist upon it. Now, it seems like an effort of will. Where you're battling and you're not sure who's going to win. Is it confusion or the continuity issue? And you just keep insisting. It's a practice of will. And the results are incredible. Because you simply deny it. No, I don't have a confusion problem. And all the... And then you can easily see what the truth is talking about, what the light is talking about, what the guru is talking about, what the savior is talking about, what the saint is talking about. You can easily, it's obvious, it's self-evident. Because you're not confused. You're not insisting on that you're confused. You don't say, guru, I tried to multiply 0 times 999, but I'm really confused. Do I go down to 998 or up to 1,000? Is 1,000 it? Or do I go down? I'm really confused over which way to move on this, you know. There's no confusion there. There's no confusion, is there? What we're really saying is, well, what do I do with all these numbers, all these imaginary values, all this motion, all this form? What do I do? I mean, where's the importance? There's no importance. There's zero importance in all form and all motion. Zero importance in all movement. Movement doesn't define pure spaciousness at all. Zero definition is taking place. So all we say is, oh, look at all this great zero definition. Oh, I love, look at that. I love this zero definition. Look at that zero definition tree and the zero definition plant, the zero definition bodies and the zero definition motion, the zero definition universe. I love this zero definition universe. Wow. Fantastic. There's some more zero definition. It's like that. So the whole universe turns into a paradise. Perfect paradise. Zero definition dog. Look at that zero definition dog. Dancing the dance of zero definition. How wonderful. Barking the bark of zero definition. Look at the gardener digging that hole, digging the zero definitional hole. Pruning the zero definitional shrubs. So you don't need to leave the feet of the guru because you're not confused. Why do you need to leave? I'm not confused. There's no such thing as confusion. There's impossibility, but there's not confusion. There is continuity problem, but sitting at the feet of the guru is how you resolve the continuity problem. Sitting at the feet of light. What is the guru? Light. Identity. I am. There's only I am. But the guru is in the form of space abiding in space. At least, that's how we see it. The guru says, fine, you can just look at it this way. Maybe some come and sit for a little while and they say, okay, but I'm still confused. There is no confusion. Nobody's confused. No one is confused. There's no such thing as confusion. This is very important. What people are saying is, I still have a continuity problem. So if you catch that and say, wait, I still have a continuity problem, then you realize, okay, everything's fine. It's just taken a little while to get used to this. So you don't break it in your mind by saying, wait, I'm confused, because then you start thinking, okay, what motion defines our identity? You know, and the motion starts in your mind. You're thinking about motions. Motion. A form. Going here, going there. What do I need to do? Where do I need to go? How do I need to alter form? How do I need to move form around? How do I live my life? How do I move around? How do I move around? It's all zero. It's all zero right now. It's always zero. I'm here right now. Everything I need to know is right now. Everything I need to know about the entire universe, I know right now. And then when you don't need to leave the feet of the guru, you are the guru. You say, everything I need to know about the entire universe, I know right now, right here, right now. Then you don't, you are the guru. Because you're not leaving that, are you? Everything I need to know, I know right here, right now, this instant. And that is, all motion is utterly meaningless. All motion of all form, all motion which implies some form, right, is totally meaningless in terms of definition, as zero definition is taking place. Nothing is taking place in terms of defining what we are. Nothing is taking place ever. Right now, I know this right now. What else is there to know? Nothing else to know. I don't need to make another motion to know this, because I already know that's zero definition. It's all zero definition. The entire universe is zero definition. So you know the whole universe right now. And that's permanent knowledge, isn't it? If you know that all motion and change is zero definition, how is motion and change going to change that realization? It doesn't change it at all, does it? It's a permanent realization. So this is what I'm experiencing, but I still have a continuity problem, so I'm aware of that. So I'm not going to say I'm confused about this. I'm not confused. But I'm still jittery about it. So I'm not the guru, you see. The guru is there's no longer a continuity problem. The guru has resolved the continuity problem. They're completely at peace with that they know everything there is to know about the entire universe. That it's completely, it's zero definitional. Absolutely zero. Nothing is happening. In terms of definition, absolutely nothing. And they're at peace with that. Whereas the rest of us, those who sit at the feet of the guru, we still have a continuity fear. And it's like, yeah, but I'm shaking. I'm shaking. Like, wow, wow, wow. Yeah, okay, that's fine. Guru in training. We're being groomed to be a guru, right? We're being groomed. Absolutely. I am being groomed. I am being groomed. You are being groomed. We're being groomed. But certainly this is, very clear to me. Very clear. I'm just like, whoa, can I even think this? Can I say this? I mean, what? Wow, wow, wow. Right now, right here, right now, I know everything. So do you. So does everyone. This is a fact. There's nothing to be added or subtracted. That's all motion. Zero times zero is zero. I'm just multiplying zero times zero. The zero definitional universe. Yeah. So the guru is the one that knows there's no confusion and refuses to accept that there is. Doesn't accept that there is. The one that says, I know everything there is to know. And of course people say, that's totally arrogant. You're crazy. I mean, all the motion hasn't even happened yet. We're still doing all sorts of modifications. We're all mods here. We're doing modification. What do you mean you know everything? Everything hasn't happened yet. Nothing, no definition will ever happen. It's all meaningless, aimless, zero times zeroness. So do we not already know that zero times zero is zero? So all the zeroness there is isn't going to change what we know already, that it's zero. It doesn't change it at all. So this is unchangeable knowledge. So that's all the guru knows. That's all there is to know about the universe. So you may think the guru knows all so much, and you're so arrogant to think that you can know as much. No, the guru only knows zero times zero. That's all there is to know. You can't really misplace this. Once you realize that knowledge, you can't misplace it. Because there is no confusion about it. Thinking doesn't change it at all. Thinking is still zero. Nothing is happening. Nothing is being defined. How can you misplace that? So the guru knows that this knowledge can't be changed, it can't be lost, it can't be misplaced. It's not possible. It's not possible. So knowing everything about the universe, that can't be lost. Because you know, how can you lose if you know everything? How can you lose it? You know everything about the universe, which is there's nothing. It's nothing. It's zero times zero. To relate, we say it's zero times zero. To reference it all, we say zero times zero. And nothing will ever happen with time, space, form, space, motion, space. Nothing will ever happen in terms of definition. Zero. Always will be zero. We can say, oh, this is a lovely zero. Lovely form of zero. It's also lovely, you know. So many varieties of zero. But again, it's still completely zero. And we don't lose sight of this. So the guru can still see and appreciate, oh yes, it's lovely, but they never lose sight of knowledge. Well, lovely form of zero. Get the jitters, you're like, oh. So, seeing all this, saw it last night, listening to Srina Nisargadatta Maharaj, a simple chapter, and it was like impact, boom, clear as a bell, boom, 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 boom. I just understood exactly what he was saying. Totally speaking right to what we're talking about here. You say, wow. I get it. It's very clear. Very clear. There's no confusion. There's no confusion. There's no definition taking place. So where's the confusion? We keep saying, I'm confused about this definition. Is it this? Is it this? Is it this? No, there's zero definition taking place. So where's the confusion in zero? There's no confusion. Again, it's as simple as let's say here's this spaciousness, pure spaciousness, and we put a bottle here, we put this bottle. Is the pure spaciousness suddenly been defined by this bottle? Is it suddenly different now? It's been defined by the bottle? Or is it still exactly the same as it was? Just all one seamless pure spaciousness. Was it suddenly changed? Now it's different. It's different pure spaciousness. Is it suddenly changed? No, not a slightest bit has it been changed. The immaculateness. The immaculateness of pure spaciousness is untouched. The purity is untouched. It's untouched spaciousness. It's unchangeable spaciousness. It's indefinable, therefore it can't be defined. This bottle does not define it. Does any motion, define it? It does not get defined. It does not get defined. Now we can say, okay, well, let's throw something up. It seems more lovely. Oh, okay, the flowers. Do the flowers define it now? Is it like this? Like this? Is that defining the pure spaciousness? We think, well, there's a difference, you know. Is there some difference between the flower and the glass? You know, the dance of the flower and the glass, is that somehow changing pure spaciousness? Does pure spaciousness say, oh wow, I've just been defined. You brought a flower in, now you define what I am. Is I am looking to define itself? Is the spaciousness in which this flower is that being defined by the flower, changed by it, identified by it? So everything has equal loveliness in this space, zero times zero. Everything has this equal loveliness of presence as space. Equal presence. And that quality is intrinsic, essential. It is the overriding quality then of zero times zero. Everything is equally blessed as non-defining. See, this is a non-defining bottle. How wonderful. What a blessed bottle. It's a non-defining bottle. This is a non-defining flower bouquet. And this is a dance, a non-defining dance of the non-defining bottle and the non-defining flower bouquet. It's a non-defining dance. What a wonderful non-defining dance. Everything is a non-defining dance. What a wonderful non-defining dance it is. So everything has this, it's just this quality of oneness, of non-definingness. You see, if everything is non-defining, is it not all one then? Is it not all the same? Is it not all one? One non-defining dance is taking place. It's just this one non-defining dance, an infinite complexity of non-definition. Yeah, we can just enjoy that as, you know, switch off the fan, enjoy the fan. Gradually going slower and slower and slower and slower. Just enjoy that. Enjoy the non-defining dance, self-released into the non-defining dance. The non-defining space, self-released into the non-defining space. Enjoy the non-definition of everything. Now again, insist I am not. I don't have a confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. Value. So, again, everything that's being said here is totally clear to everyone. Actually, it's all completely self-evident. There is no confusion about it. There is a continuity fear, and to the extent we can accept this, then again, we're immediately at the feet of the guru. You see. As soon as we say we have a confusion problem, then every problem imaginable seems to arise. There's endless confusion arises. In hell, you're in hell. You're lost. You're off the tracks. Just like that. You say, how'd that happen? Oh my God. Because we're not confused. There is no confusion. We're mystifying the continuity problem, and so we're not working on it. See, when you're at the feet of the guru, automatically you're working on the continuity problem. Automatically. So if you insist you have a confusion problem, you can't sit at the feet of the guru, because you say, you're not helping me. This has hurt, I've been hurting me, my confusion's getting worse. What's going on? You know, it's not working. So you're not there, you're not there. Even though in physical space you may think you're there, you're not there. You're thinking, how do I solve this confusion? When you say there is no confusion, then you say, but I do have a continuity problem. Then you're at the feet of the guru and you're getting familiar. You say, oh, I'm getting familiar with zero times zero. This is great. I'm really being helped. I say, it's okay to be this way. Oh, I see. It's okay to realize I'm not confused. It's okay to know everything. Yeah. I am the know-it-all. I know that zero times zero is zero. That's all there is to know. It's easy to be a know-it-all because there's only one to know. There's all this non-definition. It's all equally non-definition. So that's all that needs to be known. So of course we're a know-it-all. I used to be criticized when I was young. Everyone said, you're a know-it-all. We don't like know-it-alls here. And so I tried to change. I tried to help people with their confusion. And then I became totally confused. So, yeah. See, I am a know-it-all. Absolutely. I am a know-it-all. I am a know-it-all. Totally. I'm a total know-it-all. Absolutely. I'm a total know-it-all. Because there's only non-definition to know. Everything is equally non-definition. That's all that there is to know about the entire universe. That's all there is to know. Everything else is not knowing at all. It's self-deception. It's spiritual pride. It's arrogance. It's demanding. Hey, God, I'm really confused how do I change you again, God? How do I change what you are? How do I define what you are, God? I'm really confused about this. That's nothing but spiritual pride, desire to be greater than God. And that's again, nothing. Meaningless. Meaningless. Totally meaningless. No confusion there. It's impossible. There's no confusion about how do I do the impossible. It's not possible. Where could there be confusion? It's not there. It's not there. But the continuity fear is there. So, again, when we accept that we have a only problem is the continuity problem, right away, we feel we're at the feet of truth, the feet of light, the feet of the guru, the saint, the savior, the sage, the enlightened one. Or the enlightened oneness, the enlightened knowing, the know-it-all. We're at the feet of the know-it-all. Thank God. And then we think, oh, wait, I don't want people to think I know it all. I say, no, yes, yes. Why? There's no confusion. So how can you not know it all? It's just I need to get used to being a know-it-all. I have a continuity issue. So let me just get familiar with it. Let me get used to it. Continuity means I need to get used to it, I need to get familiar with it, I need to get comfortable with it. But yes, I am a know-it-all. I just need to get comfortable with it. That's it. There's no confusion at all. I am a know-it-all. How could there be confusion? I am a know-it-all. And that's okay. It's okay to be a know-it-all. In fact, everyone's a know-it-all. They just have a continuity issue with it. says, maybe it says, it's, okay, that's time, enough taping. So I am a know-it-all. I am a know-it-all, absolutely. Because there's only non-definition to know. There's only the one non-definition, non-definitional universe to know. That's it. Zero times zero. I know that right now. See, those who insist on confusion say, well, you don't know it yet, everything yet, because there's all this time. And what is time but measurement of motion? But if motion is totally meaningless, has zero definitional qualities, what is time then? Also zero definitional qualities to it. So is there really time? Is time meaningful? No, it's meaningless. Absolutely meaningless. It's zero. You could say there's zero time. Zero time, zero, zero time, zero space, zero time, zero form, zero. Fine, yeah, let's do that. But when is zero time? Zero time is right now. So you can be a know-it-all right now. Right now, I know everything there is to know about the universe. Right now, I know everything there is to know about the universe. Right now. And people say, hey, but you haven't seen my complete dance. I say, I've seen your complete dance, absolutely. I know the complete dance. It's the dance of non-definition. I know the outcome of all dances is zero. It's that way right now. I know it's the non-definitional dance. So what else does there know about it? Nothing. Can't be added to, can't be subtracted to. So it's the non-additional, non-subtractional, zero-definitional dance. It means nothing. And that dance is complete right now. The totality of that dance is right now. The total impact of that dance is felt right now, because there's zero impact. This is the zero impact moment right now. It's always zero impact moment. But that can be felt right now, can't it? So feeling is right now, but can be felt right now, can be experienced right now. All impact from all time can be felt right now because it's zero impact. It can be known right now. All time and space and the whole universe forever and forever can be known right now. Zero impact, zero meaning, zero definition. That can be known right now. Zero times zero can be known right now, can't it? No need to wait on that. There's nothing to add to that knowledge, nothing to subtract from it. So I am the know-it-all. I am the know-it-all. All right, very great, that's it. I am the know-it-all.